Lucky just lies there, wasted.
Well, I received a request through YouTube to go ahead and check out this map here. This is called Doom, the Argent Cathedral by Amnu, and that map ID is N2TUP2AG. Currently sitting with 4 plays and all of them upvotes, so, and I've also heard some pretty good things through the grapevine, so I'm pretty excited about this. Take a look at that author profile. Nice armor. That is so cool. It's like, you know, like, I am a knight. I am a knight. A knight of the night. Very cool. Amnu has played 3 days and 13 hours of SnapMap content, accumulated 127,000 SnapMap points. Says here, Amnu is the author of 30 total maps. That number could be higher, because again, that number does stop at 30. So, and is currently rocking a 78% upvote rating. Without further ado, let's go ahead and check out this map, Doom, the Argent Cathedral. Well, Amnu presents... Doom, the Argent Cathedral. Nice. Loki, the treacherous one, after the death of King Odin, the powers of Argent were uncontrolled. His son Loki is a load of morphing and fire, and he's trying to overtake all the powers of the Argent source. Find and stop Loki. We can do this. We can do this. Well, that was exciting stuff, man. That was a great way to open things up. Okay, so we got ourselves a door here. We're going to open up the gate, and... Lordy Lou, look at this. Argent Cathedral Courtyard. Yeah, hi. Hello, dude. What's up? Psst, come over here, Huelman. Alright, you got some blinky geo up there in the background, by the way. Just letting you know, but you might want to check and make sure it's not going into the side of the grid room, because that will sometimes cause that issue. But, I mean, this is freaking amazing looking. Oh, you definitely got some bits and bobs that are going into the walls. If your geo crosses the barrier, then, yeah, you'll get that sort of blinky geo thing going on. Oh, and the other thing, we are wearing the Praetor suits. As I like to let people know, you're taking character choice away from people by not letting them wear their own armor, but more importantly, depending on who you talk to, there are certain bugs that only happen when you're wearing the Praetor suit, so hopefully we don't run into them. In any case, let's go talk to this this helpful imp here, who by no means has anything bad to say or do to me. Hey, what's up, impy? Please don't kill me and listen. Okay? I must, or must not. Are you here to find Loki, the son of Odin? Stepson, but yeah. He is in the cathedral, but the demons are guarding it with their lives. Man, how do you talk in two colors, man? That's... Try to stay alive and kill Laufey the Guardian to open the cathedral doors. Okay, I can do this. What other weapons? Oh man, I have a plethora of weapons. All right, whoa. Okay, who's stomping around? What's this garbage? Now, a lot of folks I talk to, they say, you know, you go on about the Praetor suit thing, but I've never run into it. I'm like, I've got video recording of it. I've been one personally to say, well, I've never run into this bug, but I'm certainly not saying that being incredulous or whatever. You know, it's usually because, well, I haven't run into that bug. Could you give me what I would have to do to reproduce that bug? And a lot of people will do that, but, you know, it's interesting how many people I talk to that go, well, I've never run into the bug, and it seems like they're implying the bug therefore doesn't exist. It's like, it is documented, like, not just by me either, but whatever, you know. I mean, the other thing is, like, you know, even if, I can't remember who I told this, I was like, they are very powerful, unnoticed. It's like, you know, even if you don't believe in the, Praetor suit boogeyman, then, you know, the other point I like to bring up is, you know, you are technically taking player choice away from the player. You know, they spent snap map points on their armor because they want to use it. Now they can't use it. So, you know, all I ask is, why are you doing it? You know, I mean, I'm sure there's a, and I really need to pay attention to my health instead of going on about weird shit. So, well, that was me testing the death system. We'll call it that. So anyway, that was me dying again. Holy cows! All right. So this board is wow. Okay. Gotta be a little higher on the skill side to get through without dying. What's back here? Gorgeous looking board. I mean, it's super great looking. All right. Fine. Do you wanna get froggy? Let's do this. Welcome to my world. That's what I'm calling this little back area. My world. Oh, jeez. All right. Okay. Spam over here. Got some more healthy health over here. Okay. All right. We can. All right. So now that we have fully explored, okay, I can kind of use this as my 300 choke point if I'm smart and capable, and handsome. I am none of these things. Why am I back here? Ah! There we go. So, yep. Do I have anything bigger than a red box here? I do. Okay. Oh my goodness, this is unrelenting. Holy cow. Yeah, if you look in the distance here, you can kind of see there are bits of wall that are blinking in and out of existence. I don't want to belabor the point. I just want to make sure that I am specifically pointing out what it is I'm talking about when I say Blinky GM. So, but it's, don't want to build too close to the walls. I can help it. This is an insane battle here. Oh man, I had a siphon grenade the whole time? Boy. You know, the problem isn't always that the board's too hard. Sometimes it's I'm just not aware of all my tools and what's the slowness going on there. Doggone it. Alright, fine. Gatling gun it is. Let's do this. Yeah, yeah. Right. Old Painless says hi. Yeah. Now what other fun weapons we got here? We got the, micro missiles. Hey, I like micro missiles. Regular version, not the mastery. Okay. Again, that's neither here nor there, just checking, you know, like... What? I don't have all the best toys off the top? No, it ain't like that, man. I'm just happy to be shooting Skeletors in the pee-pee here. So, okay. Alright, so armor, 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 armor! Thank you! Oops. Oh, doggone it. Where'd he come from? There's two of them! Oh, jeez. Through the face. Guys, unrelenting bastards to a man. Or to a demon, I guess. Alright. Get the armor, get the armor. Where are you at? There you at. Oh, jeez. Loot for your shenanigans. Shield guys. Oh, and now we get to face Loffy the Guardian. No Fae or Offrey or Jeff. I don't know. Some cultures might pronounce it Jeff. Ever been to stupid Bastardia? I was there briefly while I was being born there, I guess. Oh, it's a Baron. Okay. Oh my goodness. All my good weapons are out of stuff here. Well. This where it has very little patience for the for the uninitiated here. My those health packs haven't respawned yet, and there's dudes shooting at me in the alley. Wah! Have any more rockets? Yes, I do. Eh, don't call it. Alright then. Old painless it is. Go ahead, tell me the bug doesn't exist. There. Okay. Now I think I only got to deal with Luffy McTuffy here. Alright, so, and he appears to be stuck. Can I cheese? Can I cheese? Not quite. Not as stuck as I thought, but he's definitely having a little bit of an issue with the Geo here, which hopefully used to my advantage here. Let's get that plasma rifle out. Oh, well, so much for that idea. Yarr. Oh, and he is unstunnable. That is a neat trick I sort of figured out recently. You can actually make your dudes so that they can't be stunned. And basically what you got to do is you got to use the stagger override. It. Like, basically, if you put the stagger override to, some ridiculously low number, 1 or 2% or something like that, and for some reason that I haven't quite figured out yet, it makes it so that the stun mod on the plasma rifle no longer works on them. I think that's what's happening here. So. Which is unfortunate, because it does take away some of the purpose of the plasma rifle. That's neither here nor there. You know, it definitely does make your boss battles a little more challenging. Don't use the chain gun on him. Whoa, that was really weird looking.
What happened? This sucks.
Okay, wow, yeah, so he's definitely beefed in several ways there. I was actually looking at my health at the time. I had 73 health, and that fireball took it all. Guy is not playing around. Thank goodness for the functional immortality, at least. The fact is, I got weapons in my arsenal I'm really afraid to use now, so... one of those situations where I'd definitely like to just have the chain gun out so I can just sort of set it and forget it and concentrate on circle strafing, and I don't necessarily want to do that because taking gambling. Can I go between his legs? Ah, there. Take that, Lofty. Or Luffy, or whatever your name is. Alright, I've got the great key card. Alright, and fill up everything here. Did I ever manage to figure out where shotgun ammo was to be procured? I don't remember. Alright, let's just move along. Alright, next. And I will say it again, let's just take another great look at this. Oop, yeah, you got stuff touching the walls. But anyway, Blinky Geo aside, this is a very cool looking board. Okay. Argent Cash. What's the Argent Cash going to give us? Yep, Argent Cash. What's in this Christmas present globe orb you've given me here? Odd. 125% HP and ammo points. Cool. Alright. That's good. Super shoddy. Thank you, buddy. The old dice show has been reunited. Bunch of robot and shotgun explosive shells mastered. Nice. Alright. All right. There's a happy boy. All right, let's touch
your
the...
soul will burn.
Sure. Oh, man, it's doing the blurry thing again. So there's a weird bug I've run across. I don't know what exactly triggers it, but sometimes when you push that floaty icon thing, sometimes it makes your vision all blurry, and I'm not sure... Oh, hi, Hall of Asgard. I would love to admire you, but right now I'm a little nearsighted. But anyway, yeah, it basically turns Doom Guy nearsighted. The only way I've found to, like, fix that in-game is to perform a glory kill. Oh, jeez, just exactly the thing I want to deal with while I'm in blur mode. Alright, that appears to be another Baron. Come on, get it. One thing I've discovered that can fix it, that you can do as a self-fix, is if you perform a glory kill, that is two Barons. Anyway, perform a glory kill, and it usually fixes it. Dang it! Of course, you know. Good luck performing a glory kill on these guys. Where are all these lost souls coming from? And sometimes it goes away on its own. But... Let's see if this fixes it. Yes, it does. Good. Dying works too, apparently. Okay, I've tested that solution. And I found that it works. Okay. At least this time around. What just happened there? Okay, wow. Okay. I'm not sure. Whoa! Yep, there's more blink. Wow, okay, this frickin' room looks awesome, by the way. Finally getting to notice it. What is... Oh, there's some invisible thing that's getting in my way over here. Yeah, there's like... catching myself on something invisible over here. Yeah, dang it. Yep, there's definitely... something solid and invisible over here. Oh! There we go. I have to do a ritual to open the secret door. Help me stay alive. Oh, man. Is this an escort mission? Oh, boy. Oh, I just noticed one of them's Taylor Head. That's great. So it's Taylor Head. I'll kill you last. I like you. I will kill you last. Valkyrie or something. Oh, well, sorry, Taylor Head. I killed you second to last. Alright, and I see another Keiko. Dead. Good. Okay, where'd you go? Nice looking chandeliers, what I could kind of see of them there for a second. Alright, is there any more armor in this room? We need to consider that. Man, those are some cool looking, like, kind of look like bookshelves from a distance. Might be the intention, but man, I'm really digging some of the architectural design that's going on here. Get away from that person. That is my imp buddy. And he is the most helpful and trustworthy thing in this entire board. I certainly wouldn't trust the likes of you to pick the onions out of my salad. Not that I ask people to do that for me. Much. Here he is, the only being in this entire universe here that seems willing to help me out. Give me a little bit of help to find Loki. Y'all are trying to attack him. He said, stop it! He said, cut it out! Alright, more armor, please. Thank you. everybody just a little bit tougher than normal today? What's going on here? All right, there we go. All right, did that do the thing? All right, it looks like it did the thing. All right, so let's stop, take a look around at that, man. Holy cow. Ceiling fixtures are just phenomenal. Really nice looking. It's a really great looking hall, like I said. So yeah, to reiterate, if your objects are crossing the border there, then you're going to get that blinky stuff. Also, if you look really close up there at the edge, you'll see there's some light leakage going on. That's usually because your ceiling is too thin. Could also be that it's not quite meeting the edge. I can't tell whether or not I'm seeing grid room through that, but that's what causes that stuff. Okay, all right, we got another robot to punch. I do like punching robots. All right, machine gun rocket mastery. Cool, good. All right. All right, what's up, Ymir? Primer. Ymir. Glenn. I can pronounce it Glenn if I want to. Alright, well that's what I get for trying to pronounce it Glenn, I guess. Well, you don't like Glenn? Glenn is a perfectly suitable name, dude. There are many fine people that are named Glenn. I know, I'm a god. I deserve a better name than a human. I gotta say about that? Shut up, Glenn. Yeah. Shut up, Glenn. Alright, that's kind of neat the way they did the transitional, although given all of the decoration that's going on here anyway, I don't know that they necessarily needed to do that, but it's still cool to be able to incorporate that effect. Oh, they probably want square doors. That's another explanation. Okay, so, hey, Balder. This must be your gate. Is this Balder's gate? Yeah. Yes, it is. I'll make the same joke twice. I don't care. Holy cow, it is dark in there. It's dark in everywhere. Oh, my goodness. All right. Okay, so this darkness can bite me. I have a feeling what's going on is that there's some geo-blocking the module's natural lighting. Like, there's always a point in all of the modules where natural light comes from. And if you block it with a piece of solid geo too closely, then you get these impenetrable pools of darkness. Only thing that shows up in them is, like, anything with a classic texture or, you know, of course, if you shine a light. All right, it's Loki's maze. All right, hi. What's up, trustworthy dude? Heimdall? Heimdall? This is Loki's maze. We have to be careful because of my brothers. Alright, Heimdall. What's up? We have a pact with Loki to defend the maze and the exit. Darn it. Great, so you know the way through, though, right? Maybe Loki is here in this maze? Oh, maze. Alright. And, of course, that is the extent of your help. Alright. Alright. Oh, well, hello, dude. Oh, out of quarters. Yeah, well, that'll refill my ammo at least. Okay. Alright. Something's getting thumpy around here. Is that another Hell Knight? Yep, that is another Hell Knight. regen. Yay! The exact opposite of what I thought would happen. Damn my expectations. Ah, dang it, out of quarters again. Alright. Better switch to another weapon here, because just about to run out anyway. I don't want to suddenly have to be using another weapon in the middle of a firefight. All right, hey, cool. All right, good. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Oh, well. Buddy. Right, any more? Any more dudes? Any more dudes? All right. Boy, okay, I got a haste. I'm not sure what going faster in this place is going to help me do. But, okay. There we go. Alright. Okay, I am hearing some grunty grunts, so there you are. Do it. Anyone else? Anyone else? A door has finally opened somewhere. Alright, cool. Probably not that one. Oh, there we are. Okay. Only one place where he can be. Follow me. Okay. You've been pretty on the level so far. I think I could trust you with my life. That's the reason why Loki is here. Okay. Cool. I am here. Whoa! New Hell King. Oh, was I fooled by an imp? Well, if you can't trust an imp. That's okay. Guess what, dude? I am more immortal than you are, technically, so. Man. Another situation where I'd really be happy to have the chain gun right now. Alright, alright. Alright, why don't we switch to big ordnance, because it looks like I have a better room to move here than I did in the other place, so. Ah. Decided to call out your friends, huh? Yeah. In the face of an imp, the most trustworthy and lovely face in this entire game. How dare you? How dare you? Alright, where'd you go? There you are. Alright, yeah, I'm still out of rockets. I want to use the chain gun, because last thing I want is to be this far in and bug again. Be stunned? You cannot be stunned. Alright. Yep. Oh, hey, more buddies. Apparently also cannot be stunned. Oh. Ready to fire aside. Really starting to think the this gun is not helping me too much. Where'd they go? Oh, there's one. There's the other. Okay. Oh. Let's not be too hasty here. Okay, so now might be a good time to switch to the old dice show. Alright. Alright, incoming. Oh boy, another one?
You think this is how it ends?
You know, they always ask me that. Have to answer no, I was actually kind of expecting that it would turn out it was me the whole time, and you know, Katamari was a lie and all that fun stuff, but you know, honestly, I'm too tired. Let's just move. All right, so okay, your rage, well, you go back to 100%, has made me pretty angry, I will not lie. So, I gotta say, calling me immortal rings pretty hollow when I can just keep coming back from the dead. Locust summons fire and demons, okay. Well, this mortal, quote-unquote, will be right back. Okay. Okay. Hasn't regened yet. That's fine. I'll just die. Of course he does. Of course Loki summons a Baron. Anyway, what's another five? Yeah, invisibility, if I can get to it today. Hey, that worked out. Okay. So another interesting problem we run into here is because you're using one Baron that is Loki and one Baron that isn't, it is kind of, I mean, I realize, okay, I'm just now realizing, okay, yeah, he's using the God of Trickery. That's probably part of the point. That said, it is difficult for me to prioritize targets when there's no POI. So, but I can also say, okay, well, this is meant to be Loki, the God of Trickery, so that would actually kind of make sense. So, I won't list it as a complaint, merely an observation. Say, you know, hey, good job. Yeah. If there's any god that should definitely be the god of no POIs ever, it would be Loki. Or, you know, even better, putting the wrong POIs on things would be another great thing for him to do. Where'd he go? Oh, there he is. Speaking of things that would be befitting Loki, this is probably one of the few bosses I've encountered in a while, like, one of the few, like, sort of enhanced special effect enabled bosses that doesn't seem to be using teleport, and I feel like a teleport would be ideal for him. I am not the one? No, you are not the one. Alright. Button we press. You've killed Loki. Mission successful. Huzzah. Okay, well, you know, let's sort of break things down there. So, first of all, obviously, I was experiencing a little frustration because I did run into the old Praetor suit bug there. And as a result, was sort of afraid to whip out the chain gun for most, well, all of that second run. This is a very hard board, you know, from a combat standpoint. It's not easy, and I'm sure there's people that can get through it once without dying. I am certainly not one of them. So there's that to consider. From what I could tell, pretty much all the enemies, most if not all the enemies, are juiced in some way. They're definitely like they've had their either their health or their damage or both upped a little bit. So, which is neither here nor there. There's some folks that dig that sort of challenge upping, and then there's others that don't. I'm sort of, you know, if you have, as far as I'm concerned, if your board has, you know, that sort of immortality thing going on, the functional immortality, and you just can't die anyway, then, you know, and dying won't end the game, then it's whatever. You know, I mean, you just, you know, the challenge there just becomes, you know, trying to die as little as possible. That said, I didn't feel that this board really had any sort of a consequence for dying. You know, there was a point in time when I just was really just sort of letting my guard down because I was like, hey, you know, it's honestly easier to die than it is to find the ammo pickups. So, I mean, good job having the ammo pickups sort of respawn and everything. That's great. Make sure you never run out and that sort of thing. At the same time, I felt like all the ammo pickups were in very, like, either inconvenient or difficult to locate on the fly sort of places. It's worth thinking about. I mean, the health of the ammo pickups were easy enough to find, but again, when the only consequence of dying is you get all your ammo back, then, you know, it's sort of neither here nor there. So those are all things to consider. We definitely pointed out several places where your geo is blinking. What happens is when you're building and you let some of that blocking volume be outside of the boundaries of the grid room, then that's typically what causes that blinking geo effect, is when your geo is crossing that boundary into the outside of the module. And so what you might want to do is, like, just sort of go in there and adjust thicknesses and just get your geo back inside the grid room proper, and make sure that, you know, it's not crossing over those walls. So that's definitely something to think about. And one huge thing, I mean, and this is, I didn't really want to bring it up again until after I finished the board, but personally, I can't figure out why the Praetor suit was made mandatory for this board. I mean, you know, one of those things I've been trying to do with this is, you know, a lot of folks are saying, well, I've never run into the bug, or the bug's not a problem for me, or even in some cases, oh, there's no such bug, or whatever. But, you know, regardless of what you think of the bug, and again, I've got documented, you know, I've got documentation proving it exists, and I was even able to trigger the bug in this very board. If you don't believe in the Praetor suit bug, there's also the question of, okay, well, why was I dressed as the Doom guy? What for what specific narrative reason was I forced to not wear my own custom armor. And honestly, I couldn't see one in this board. I didn't see anything in the story that would have been different or changed in any way by me wearing my custom armor. So what I would say is consider removing the campaign model checkmark when you republish, because I don't think the story would have changed one whit by anybody using their custom armor. So those things out of the way, I will say the Doom, the Argent Cathedral is a beautiful looking board. It's very gorgeous looking, great use of the grid room space, and I like that one, especially that one passage where you use the portal effect to kind of have a cool thing as you're going through that hallway. That was a really neat thing to do. Nice little use of Loki as like the imp that becomes the big demon. That was really, really cool. I can recommend this board. Obviously I would recommend it with the, caveat, don't use the chain gun if you are prone to dying. And if you do use the chain gun, prepare for a gamble. So anyway, that's Doom, the Argent Cathedral, map ID N2TUP2AG, and I had some fun with it. Game over, game over, game over, game over, game over.